I'm Cave Joel, and today is Star Wars Day, May the 4th, and what a better day than any for the final episode of the final season of Star Wars Clone Wars to hit the Disney Plus app. This is the video series, of course, where I give my thoughts and feelings on the episode that was, as well as shouting out any bigger themes or ideas I can find. So, with that out of the way, let's hop into it, shall we? So, picking up directly from where the previous episode left off, Ahsoka had managed to save Rex from his control chip, but they're still very much cornered by an army of kill-crazy clone troopers. Also, this didn't hit me last time, but it hits me like a ton of bricks. Now, the extra added salt in the wound of this whole thing is that Ahsoka and Rex must not only battle their brothers in arms, but the very same clones who have painted their face to honor Ahsoka. Meanwhile, Darth Maul figures if he can't escape the way he wanted to, then he'll do the very next best thing, and that is destroy the ship's engine room and kill everyone alongside him. This scene reminded me a lot of the use of Force powers by Starkiller in the video game Force Unleashed. Yeah, I know he's not canon anymore, but still, this also adds a nice little ticking clock element here for everyone involved in the finale. Now, this episode is really built around a major moral conundrum for our heroes. Is it right to kill these clones, even if it means that they can live, especially considering that we've spent so long in this series getting to know each and every one of these clones, really feeling them as people, and for Rex, the only family he's ever known. It's Rex, the career soldier, who says that they should shoot their way out, even if it has to be the hardest call they ever make, something he says quite literally with tears in his eyes. It's Ahsoka, though, who fires back by vowing to not be these men's executioner under any circumstance. So if killing is out, instead they decide to try and play it smart. Maybe Rex can pretend to still be under the sway of his control chip and argue that Ahsoka should be spared because, well, technically she's not a Jedi anymore and she hasn't been for a long time. Sadly, Jesse and the others are way too far gone by this point, but the stalling tactic does give the droids a chance to mess with the ship controls. Speaking of the droids, I never much cared for the episodes of Clone Wars that featured them as main characters, but damn if I don't end up getting super invested in their ultimate fates. Here they help out in a major way, and then they ultimately bite it. It's much sadder too when you stop and think that this was a show that was built around showing us the humanity and compassion that all the clones have, and when it comes to droids, meh, we don't really treat them like equal citizens. It's here too Darth Maul ends up scoring probably his biggest victory of the arc by managing to commandeer the only escape ship. Granted, his victory will be short-lived, as we all know. He gets to go back to a life of crime, only to have his Shadow Collective stomped out by the new Empire soon enough. Then he goes crazy in a cave for a little bit looking for holocrons, only to be killed by Obi-Wan Kenobi for a second time. Despite being overwhelmed for most of the episode, Ahsoka and Rex actually managed to take out a massive amount of clones almost single-handedly, and they did it while holding back too, not too shabby. When things look really bad too, Ahsoka even force pushes Rex away into a Y-Wing with hopes that he can save himself before the ship crashes. And it's here we actually get a very nice callback to the first episode of this arc, where Ahsoka is able to basically halo jump from the falling ship and catch a ride before it's all over. And even though our two heroes survived, they certainly didn't win. A bunch of their friends are dead, the universe has fallen to the Empire, and now they're gonna have to go into hiding. Ahsoka and Rex have a funeral for the fallen clones, and she even ends up leaving her lightsaber behind. Keep in mind, it was the last gift from Anakin, a man that she trusted above all else, who helped usher in a new era of darkness. Ahsoka leaving that lightsaber too actually proves to be really important, because many years later, Darth Vader finds the crash site and assumes that she must have died along with Rex and the others. This actually ends up answering a very important question fans have had for a long time now, and that is, why did Vader never look for her and Rex? Come to think of it, Vader looking at all is actually brilliant in and of itself, because you can interpret this scene in one of two ways. Either a piece of Anakin is still alive and wanted to know the ultimate fate of his two friends, or transversely, Vader wanted to kill the last two surviving people who really knew Anakin Skywalker as a person, thereby fully completing his transformation into Darth Vader. But wait, this scene gets even better, because when Vader looks up in the sky, he sees a very familiar bird flying around. It's Moray, the animal companion of the Daughter, one of the godlike force beings of planet Mortis. You'll recall that the Daughter seemingly imprinted on Ahsoka when the two of them had met back in that very episode. We actually saw the bird too all over Rebels when Ahsoka and Vader had their final battle, then again when Ezra helped save Ahsoka from the time stream in the Space Between Spaces. In fact, the portal to the Space Between Spaces was itself a giant mural dedicated to the Daughter and her family. Again, I think this is genius because you can interpret this scene in a lot of ways. Does the bird represent the light side of the Force, and because it's so far away now from Anakin and circling like a vulture as if to say Vader is the death of the light side, but that the light side is still very much alive and well? Or you can get super literal with it. Is Ahsoka perhaps looking through the eyes of the bird at Vader right now? Either way, it's just so freaking cool, and I lost my damn mind when I saw it. And so that was Victory and Death, and honestly, I thought it was everything I wanted from a Clone Wars finale. It was exciting, it was tragic, the action scenes were stunning, some of the best of the series, and heck, there was at least even one really funny joke about Rex's rank. It was good too, even though I knew full well that Ahsoka, Rex, and yeah, Maul too will all manage to survive this into the Rebel era and beyond, but even still, I was on the edge of my damn seat. I said it before and I'll say it again, but this is good prequel writing right here. It all comes down to how much you care about the characters and their emotional journey. We're basically seeing characters we love, characters we've grown with on the darkest days of their lives, and what kind of scars that will leave behind on them will influence what they do in the future. And you know, it just wouldn't be Star Wars either if we also didn't leave the door open for more novels, video games, and comic books. Oh sure, everything gets wrapped up nicely at the end, but there are still questions that I'm sure they'll answer. Like, why did Ahsoka and Rex decide to split up at some point? What drove Maul to study the holocrons? Heck, did Ahsoka ever end up meeting Luke at any point? I mean, you would figure it would be weird if they didn't tell that story at some point, right? And so yeah, that'll just about do it for me, and we'll do it for Clone Wars as well. I'm glad I had a chance to sit down and talk about this show. I know it's really important to a lot of my viewers, and to myself too. If you want to keep up to date on every animated video I do, be sure to follow me on Twitter and Facebook so you always know when a new one is about to drop. And hey, seeing as Clone Wars is officially done and Harley Quinn will be done soon enough too for the season, what other animated shows would you like to see me cover on the channel? Tell me down in the comments section and I might just do it.